Well hello, this is Jimonism, Total Nerdy Channel, and we are back in From the Depth because I wanted to do some improvements to my little Viking ship as I learned some new stuff from the comments. Also, I find this little ship building tutorial map in Vehicle Designer where you basically can learn how to build cannons better. Now this is interesting, stuck effect in the air. So these are lots of models basically. Lots of models to build different types of weapons. Also we have lots of tips here. Stuff I didn't know. Apparently we should keep the ammo below the waterline, which makes sense. And keep the ammo away from other components we should think of. So there are basically lots of tips here which you'll try to remember. Buoyant blocks at a waterline, okay. And of course air pumps is necessary. Try to keep weapons below waterline too. Oh, that's fancy. And this kind of smart. Sloped front, of course, but leave the front empty as a damage buffer. That we should probably do too. And the AI in this is really hidden away. That's probably for the better. And propeller should be placed in line with the center of mass. I see, that's kind of makes sense. Oh well, so this is a little tutorial place. But we will load in our ship here if we can. If I can. Let's see here. Load vehicle. 6 Gedunar Beta 1. Perfectly. Version 2. Okay. Now question is, where is Runar? Interesting. So now is the question, how do you spawn things in here? I never done this. Go in here and we'll load in vehicle and yes. Okay. Spawn in vehicles share. Okay. It didn't work. Well, that's interesting. Okay, so that didn't work, but well, anyhow, I just loaded the old project basically. That works, which is nice. So what I understood is that we actually don't need to have AI connection to stuff that we have like at the moment. We seem to not, I've heard we do not need to have AI connection to the oh, what is this? Oh, that's the old. I don't think we need to have connection to the rudder. So actually we will exchange this with a little metal block, and I think it was no wrong button. Oh well, it's very sad there is no undo button on this, but oh well, I guess we need to set this now again. Yep, that seemed to be the correct thing to do. Wait. We can't use that. Okay, I guess we do the Y. Somewhere around there. Oh, yeah. Yep, that looks about right. Anyhow, we didn't need to have the AI parts there. So we can remove the that little thing too. But I also understand we do not need the AI connection to the spin block. So I'll just try and see if we'll break this connection like that. Now it's broken. And we go into the, let's see here, what is it? I try to remember all the menus. Aha.
Listening.
And we want to make it in patrol mode.
Control yours. Moving out, moving out, moving out, moving out, moving out, moving out.
Now is the question. Will it be able to maneuver this thing? Interesting. It does seem to be able to maneuver the thing. So it slowly turns while having the... Oh wow, this is some weird controlling, but it looks like it knows exactly what it's doing. The wind is totally not super favorable, but we certainly can move with this. Huh, interesting. It's not fast, but it knows what it's doing. That's cool. That also means... Oh shit! Oh no. Yeah, so that's the thing. Maybe we can load. Okay. Probably we could go into the menu here and we could load this design here. No, this does not work. It looks like we're repairing it now. So we are restoring the old version, slowly but surely. Hopefully, the old controls... Maybe we need to set the controls again, I'm not sure. Okay. We should probably have some things helping us building, like a tactical nuke. No, but... tactical nuke is kind of very cheap. Well, what we want to have is a rudder block. Now let's see here. I'm not sure where everything is, but it's the thing that repairs things. Rep- repair tentacle. I think a repair bot is what we need. We can just place this little repair bot, maybe. Like that. Here we have a little repair bot. I don't know, really, if we need to connect up this to anything. Maybe to the AI? I don't know. Whoops. Maybe just go for repair tentacle. They don't seem to help. Well, if we're broken, at least we have a repair bot to help us. I guess we need to wait for this manual stuff going on here. So while that repairs, we can try to learn if we can click the replace again. I really miss the replace feature that StarMid has. Hold shift for replace. Okay, we'll try again. Okay, shift left click. Okay, good. That we can just remove. I still believe we're... Yep. And we also learned that the AI connection is not needed. And that one needs to be replaced, like that. We can be hardcore and have a little metal lining on top of here. Oops, I think that it's kind of expensive with a AI block, so we'll not waste them. Nope, not stone. Who builds in stone, by the way? We should totally do that. I like the overlapping texture features of this. It's really nice. Now, as the AI is super expensive and stuff, I figured we should try to build some better protection for it. Like, at least protect from bombardment shells or something like that. Just have a little... ring connecting its sides a little bit. Whoops. Just like that, maybe. Something around there, maybe. Hopefully that will do it. Now, question is, are we reaching goal or not?
Listening.
Patrol.
Control yours. Listening. Listening.
Okay.
Listening. Control yours.
No.
Listening. Control yours. Moving out. Moving out. Moving out.
Okay, cool. Oh no. Oh yes, good. Now. Build mode. We should totally just take this up in the air. I just want to control that everything is working as it should. And we even have build mode here if we can. Can I? Yes, that. This looks to be like reverse. Looks like it's reverse. That should be right then. Probably so. I mean, the rudder is super strong, it's kind of weird, but oh well. Okay, so now we disconnected some AI stuff that we actually don't need. So that's good. No. Okay, it looks like we can... What is it?
Turning off.
Turn off the AI. I'm getting kind of ish to know this game a little bit more. That's nice. Alright, so I seen there is other ways to use sails, where you just have fixed sails instead of turning blocks, but I think that's so unrealistic I don't want it on my ship. I think that feature should be removed from the game. Of course, you have to have the sail on a thing that turns, otherwise it's weird. But well, that's just my opinion. We should probably put some wedges on this thing, I believe. If we just can have some symmetry planes and... Oh, probably we should have the symmetry plane this way. Is there a way to have multiple symmetry planes, like Shift N or something? No, probably not. If there is, please tell me. I would love to know that. But, well... We'll definitely have a... Now, let's see here. Downslope. Triangle. Corner. Square corner. It's... Wedge. Maybe wedge. No, wedge. Triangle. Square corner. Like... Downslope. But... Oh! Diagonal cut. This is probably what we'll need, right? That was a weird location, so... Okay, well... Interesting. Aha! Perfect. F to fill. Warp block under cursor. No? Swap. Oh. As you know, I'm getting to know this game. No. Okay, now. Okay. I'd love to place many at the same time. But I can't. So that's sad. Maybe this is one of the times when the in-game developed build mode is better. Oh, and then we move that direction, okay. Then we should right-click, I believe. Aha! Oh no! When trying to remove blocks, this is just so weird. This mode is a bit awkward when removing blocks. Okay, I guess we just have to, you know, switch between them then. Because the thing is... It gets uneven if we don't do it like that. Okay, now we can switch to this mode. We can even do like this. I must say, it's pretty handy. In its, you know, right use. Whoops. Nice. And this way. We're certainly soon we'll be having a pretty cool ship, so that's nice. And next one, perfect. Now is there a alt key, I see. I always try to, you know, learn how new games do things instead of just trying to remap all the games, because often the game developers have a pretty good idea of what's good ways to control a game. Of course, there are exceptions, but you know. Generally speaking, it's can be a good little thing to think of, or to practice, I think, at least. And I guess that's just how we can do it. It would be kind of cool is having little metal lining here, and we could put in metal slopes. Nope, this button, like a little inlay here would look pretty nice. That's cool. Now we'll just have, maybe we'll need to do some wedging after all. Now, it's the square corner, triangle corner it should be. Well, I hope it does determine the left and right by itself, because if it doesn't, it's kind of sad. Oh, is this different menu? No. Yep, no. Oh, naturally. We want 3. But it seemed to be able to determine at least that for itself, so that's really, really handy. Definitely, this will work. Now we'll just need to exchange these against the to the not square corner but inverted triangle corner part. And it even looked like it turned itself in some way. However, we seem to be unable to reach the part behind, so that's a bit sad, but oh well. Then we know that you can't multi-work like we do in StarMade with different layers as easily. Just have to put them right where they should be. Maybe that should be another one too, though. No, probably not. Well, we'll fix that later. Triangle corner, let's fill this in. Well, at least we're getting a hang of it, but... Maybe we should have some. Probably just the four down slope is good enough here. Three, I mean. That will do it. Oh, and also, I was googling a little bit, so I will want to change some details here. Just some small parts, and we want to have the three down slope like that. We want to make a snarkly, how to say it? You'll see very soon, but a shape that goes in a circular, more of a circle pattern thing. Like something around there, but with more finesse if we can. Let's see here how to that. It's the way to do it. Now, this looks a bit weird. Let's try to put some more effort into this. Like that. I'll guess that's the better. Probably that's as good as it is, as good as it gets, yes. Right, now we try to fix these whoops wedges too. Let me just save this part here. But we'll just remove the four wedges here. And I'm kind of worried to make something big mistake because there is no undo button. Oh my god, which is kind of not very nice. 3 meter inverted triangle. Whoops. Thing. Okay, apparently we work from this side. But I'm glad it determines the other side to be left. That's kind of very handy. Interesting. Something looks weird. Well, we just fill in with some triangles and hope that it works. Probably see later where we should place things. Maybe we need some of those slopes, anyways. Yeah, we do. Three, I guess. And there we have it. Our very fancily modeled Viking boat. Now, we should totally save this before we forget it. Save, yes. Have a new version. Okay, so now we have improved all the tips we got from the last video. If there is more stuff I can fix, you should totally tell me and I will try to do so. I just want to have, a kind of decent little boat to use when I start a campaign. I want something to spawn that looks cool and can help us do some work. Now, I'm not entirely sure if we will have this do combat or if we should have it do resource gathering and stuff like that too. I guess specific combat role ships is a lot cooler, but there might be good to have all around features of stuff. I don't know. Probably we could have a little compartment with resource gathering and stuff like that. It doesn't hurt. I guess the resource gathering, let's look at the resources. Fuel refinery, fuel storage. Okay, so damage storage, ammunition storage, ammo barrel. This is the same block, but the one looks cooler. Not sure which looks cooler, but well. Rocket Man. Prefab collection of blocks that can be placed. Perpetual motion. Petroleum 101. Oh my god. So this is a petroleum. Can I not have symmetry planes? Okay, thank you. Maybe I do like this. N, click N again, click N, yes. Mm. So this is a big block of petroleum things. I don't want to spawn it because there is no undo button. What I know, if there is an undo button, you need to tell me right away because I want to know it. Rocket Man. I would love a description. The Rocketman refinery is compact fuel production setup that focuses on speed rather than efficiency. Okay. Fuel production setup. Petroleum 101 refinery is a medium-sized refinery with moderate efficiency and a fuel production speed. A reasonable straight point for any supply fortress. Perpetual motion is an expensive investment. However, due to its components, it will continue to produce a small amount of engine power until the heat death of the universe. Okay. That looks expensive. Let's not do it. Aluminium processor converts metal into ammunition and stores it in ammo barrels. Cool. Material gatherer gathers material from the seabed when in resource zones using a powerful mining laser. The rate of material gathered depends on how much left in the resource zone. Okay. Resource guide. Okay, fuel storage tank. Okay. Material gatherer, fuel storage tank, okay. Fuel refinery converts material resource to usable fuel. Okay. Fuel refinery is better to refine your fuel away from combat and storage fuel on combat vehicles. I see. Material gatherer. Okay. Ammo processor makes ammunition. Ammo barrels stores ammunition. Highly explosible. Protected areas we should place them in. And that's all. Cool. Well, then we know. We just have a little oil drill. Will we use the oil drill? Let's just have a material gatherer. Because we don't want to have a refinery. We'll go into build mode though. No, I can't place this. Why can't I place this? Wait. Aha! So you can only place them like that somehow. Well, let's have a little material gather plug-in thing here at the back of the ship. And we'll have some... Downslope. That's right. Now. Did we? No, we didn't. I'm trying to learn how to point my mouse to, you know, reach things.
What?
Oh. We can't put it underwater. I see. But it should be placed downwards, I guess. That's kind of weird. Oh well. No. Oh, I removed something. Downslope 3. Like that. Okay, cool. It's so many blocks floating around, that's weird. Like, it looks like we have destroyed something big, but... it doesn't look like it, though. Oh well. Resource gatherer. Material gatherer. Well, I guess we just have this little material gatherer here. Could be nice to have. And then we have a material storage, which is small, wood, large. This is interesting. We have lots of different. This can store 500. Same material cost. Ability to store a small amount of material. Okay. This focus on a few blah blah blah. This seems to be the same block, basically. I think they had different types of materials, no? Metal. Oh, this is only different materials then? But they have the same stats, right? Because I believe they had different storage tanks for different, you know, things before, but it looks like they have, you know, you now store everything in the same type of block. Fancy. Why is this fancy? Can store more? Oh well, it looks cool. I think you had different storage tanks for different types of materials, but now it seems to be the same, which is probably for the better. It disturbs me that the material cost is the same though. That's probably should remove some of them. That stuff, I believe. I don't know how many storage materials we should have, but we have a bunch of them. I guess that's enough. We definitely have a fuel storage. Fuel storage tank. Box and tank. Is this the same values once again? But I like the tank. It's cooler. Well, I guess this is a decently safe space to store our fuel. But I'm not really sure that we should have a fuel storage, because I think we'll have a supplementary steam engine, and I guess it won't run with fuel. What we do want to have is a ammunition processor, so that we can load our vehicle. That is kind of necessary. Well, I think we'll have a little ammo compartment here. So there we have the processor. Then we will have ammunition storage going on here. Now, once again, I'm not really sure how much ammunition you're supposed to put on a ship. I just put a random amount here, like there. Okay, never mind. Resources, and we have... Nope. Ammunition processor, right there. Okay, cool. I'm not sure if one processor is enough, but we'll try. Now, I'm just wanting to check my hard drive here. It seems that I... Alright, I just wanted to check I even have space left on my hard drive, because I have a very fast SSD drive, or a decent SSD drive. I don't know if it's especially fast, but it's an SSD, so it's nice. But I also don't have very much space on it. It's only 200 gigabytes, so it's actually half the size of my previous computer. But oh well. So I just need to check that I actually have some space left to do. Oops. So I covered in the ammo here. Probably... I feel this is little ammo. Is it not? I don't know. We'll double it. Also, I want to have another... I want to have two ammo processors, because... Why not? This. We have the ammo processors on the sides there, and they can be working there. That's nice. We can have the metal block. We can actually put a beam here. Just like that. Cover them in a little bit like that. Looking good. We'll just cover them up with some beams here. And hopefully the whole thing will not be blown to bits. I'm fancy, so I want to have a slope here. Cool. Oh yeah. So there we start to have something. Some ammo, little processor for materials, I guess. That's hopefully working. To put some materials into our boxes and also load the ammunition. I feel that almost we should have another ammo processor. No, what is it? Material gatherer. Couldn't hurt to have two of them. We have a storage compartment there too, okay. Now, we will have a engine, I believe. Steam engines would be cool. This looks so modern. I would wish for some more steampunk. But oh well. Steam guide. The Steam controller is the main component of the steam engine. We can actually interact to increase or decrease resource burn rate for the attached boilers. Unlike most main components, you can have multiple steam controllers in a steam engine setup, although only one per set of boilers. The steam boiler produces steam for the rest of the components to use. So we want to have boilers along. Steam pipes allow you to provide steam to other components so that they can function. And it's easy to see the leaks, cool. Steam vents to plug leaks as well as to prevent overall pressure from exceeding safe levels. I do not want to have any safe safety. No, I don't. Sturm, the turbine generator, you can convert steam into battery power. The higher the steam pressure, the more battery power produced. Okay. That looks very fancy. Steam turbine hooks up both to the turbine generator and the steam pipe to allow the generator to function. Large turbines produce more battery power, but I don't want any battery power. Gearbox produces engine power from attached crank. Cool. The crankshaft. Oh, they don't even need to be connected. That's weird. Cool. Or yes, they have to be connected to the pistons. Alright. Shaft generator produces battery power, but I don't want any battery power. Cool. I'll guess we make a little steam engine. We're gonna have the steam engine in the front here. Okay. Steam engines. We'll have a steam control. I guess that the steam control, we could probably put the steam control back on the command deck. Oh, I'm not sure we can. Maybe we need to have it actually connected. Firebox. Decorative. Ah, I see. Turbine generator. Okay, cool. I think I get it. I understand this. I'm not sure this needs to be connected to anything, but let's have a little boiler. We will have the this is probably a good way to have the little steam engine here. We want the steam control there. I'm not sure this needs to be connected, but let's have it so. Firebox, and we want the gearbox. Maybe like that. I don't know. Gearbox small. Cased crank. What's that? And here is a crank. Oh, it's the end point of a crank thing. Who knows? Oh, let's see. Boiling chamber had no steam pipe connected to the end. I see. Well, we just have a bunch of cranks here. I don't know how many we should have. Like that. And we have Y-cased crank. It's heavier. It has more health. Okay. Casing to support the shaft. Oh no. Oh no. I removed things. Okay. That's weird. Oh no. No. How to undo? Scary. We accidentally filled stuff. Oh no. Okay, can I get a symmetry plane here? No? Damn it! Listen to me. No. What the fuck? What happened even? Can I? Is this build mode? No. This build mode. Good. Okay. Symmetry plane, thank you. Now we need to remove this trash here. Okay. There we have it. Good. Then we need to go to the steam engines. And crank, piston, shaft, extension of the shaft. That's cool. Let's have an extension of the shaft. And we have a cased crank here. And there, to make it look cool. And we can have pistons. Should have some connections like that. And I guess this is the way to connect them up. I guess we have too many cylinders and too little actual steam input. Maybe they can't move. Oh, enters the piston from the back. I see we do not have space to place them here. So I'll guess we do it like this. This looks weird. Oh wait, I have them the wrong direction. Okay, okay, now I get it. So these things will need to be connected. Kind of like that. But let's see if we can make a steam pipe connection. Shaft generators. Oh. Steam piping, okay. Pipe. Too many pipes. Pipe vent. Pipe hull. Okay. So this works. Nope. Probably not. Pipe hull then. Does pipe hull work? I don't think this will work. I think we're going to steam engines and... We need to use the... Pistons. It's so hard. No. Like that? No. Basically. Like this, but we need to put them one step up in the air. So we just do a little support thing here. Steam, where is steam? Because this is where we'll place them. Oh, getting confusing. No, why? Okay. Steam engines and gearbox and piston. Okay. That's now connected. This should work. Whoops. Now we just need lots of steam connections. Steam engines, steam piping. Now we need a... Let's see here. I guess we can only hit them from above. So corner pipe should do. Corner pipe. Whoa! We have steam. That. Then we need lots of three-way connections. Cool! Oh my god, it's working. That's kind of cool. Hmm. wonder if the boiler needs to be connected directly. We'll definitely try this. We have a small steam control. The engine stops working. Cool. Now we can just test it actually anywhere, but if I have this. Nope, it doesn't work. Okay, we need to have it connected up. Oh, but maybe we can make a tube connection. Let's try. Just for the. Okay, and then we put on steam, and we steam control small. Maximum. And if we put it down to, we can have it on very low. Burn rate 0.3 per. That's cool. Gearbox. Eleven cylinders. Question is now. Pressure vent. Probably we could have a pressure vent in the end here. Like that. Steam pressure is sinking. Decrease it with turbines and pistons, I see. So it seems like the power of it is dropping. If we turn up boiler rate is the question. Shit, now it's increasing. Ah. And then it's decreasing. It's releasing power. Oh well. That's cool. We could drag this down to very low. I guess we won't release any unnecessary power, I believe then. Now we're dwindling in power again. Well, maybe. I guess it's a shitty engine. But it's my first steam engine and I kind of like it anyways. This engine is kind of huge. Oh well. Center of mass. There we have center of mass. Then we should have propeller in center of mass. Because now we need to have a propeller. I believe we'll have a propeller here, maybe. Blocks, water. Propellers. Cool. So, and this we'll control using the this buttons. Cool. Thank you. scale by one. And it can let us gain some speed now. So that's cool. Not very fast, but you know. Complimentary. Oh, our engine is totally stopped. I guess we should just release the steam. Steam piping, okay. I think we should put on some cool piping instead. Make some fancy six-way things, no? 4 meter tubes. PayPal. Isn't this pretty cool? Wood blocks. Like that, that, and that. Yep, that's how to do it. We could go down to steam control and turn up the heat. It's slowly starting to gaining some speed. Like the sound of them. Pressure is rising. So if we go to not building mode, just you know. Probably use our steam engines to move around here. Gaining some good speed. I want to try to just go into this menu here.
Listening. Controls yours. Moving out. 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 Moving out.
Cool. I guess it's not very fast. I wonder just how inefficient our steam engine is. But it's cool. Probably make a super speed version of this sometime. Oh well, I think we'll totally just save this vehicle. Yes, save over. Oh. Should we have a... Was it F12? Captured. So if we go into the save vehicle, we have it there. Cool, that's kind of fancy. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Well, I believe that this will probably just sum up this video just fine. I guess we'll probably want to increase the lead thing on the bottom here, maybe, to make it a bit more stable, but oh well. I think we have done quite a lot today on this ship, so, well, I'll just say thank you very much for watching, and, well, I will be catching you soon. Dumadism Total Nerdy Channel, signing out.